Are you looking for an Arduino simulator? We get tons of requests over at PEA asking, hey, is there a good Arduino simulator out there? And in short, yeah, there is. In this video, we'll explain what an Arduino simulator is, why you should be checking them out, even if you already have all your Arduino hardware, and we'll do a step-by-step walkthrough using a popular and, oh by the way, free, online Arduino simulator called Tinkercad. Stay tuned. Okay, so what is an Arduino simulator? It's a virtual representation of a real-world Arduino circuit. What does that actually mean? Let's look at an example. Here you see we've created the famous Hello World blinking LED circuit with actual hardware. We've programmed the code in the Arduino IDE, we've uploaded it, and bam, we have a real-world physical circuit. I timed myself making this from start to finish, and it took me 6 minutes, or thereabouts. Here, using the free online Arduino simulator software at Tinkercad, we've created exactly the same circuit, we've used the same exact code, and after we hit the Start Simulation button, we have a virtual version of exactly the same circuit. This guy only took me a minute and 50 seconds. That is some serious efficiency. Okay, so we'll show you at the end of the video exactly how to make that demo. We will recreate it in Tinkercad. So why are simulators so cool? Well, you already saw it can be much quicker to build stuff online, so we won't belabor that point. But here are a few other quick reasons why simulators rock. First off, you can learn how to code as well as learn how to build circuits from anywhere you have a computer and internet access. That's right, no longer are you tethered to your hardware in your workshop. You can do it from literally anywhere. Number two, it's much easier to track down hardware and wiring errors in the simulator. It can be very difficult to visualize where wires are connected to and which pins on a busy breadboard. But if you get it right in the simulator, then recreating it in the real world goes much, much smoother. And lastly, you can share your design with peers for feedback and get help with solutions. So instead of posting your code to a forum and hoping that someone knows what your circuit looks like or they ask you a bunch of questions about it, you can do both at the same time. Just share your link to your project and everybody can see exactly what your code is and what your circuit is. It is much more efficient this way. Okay, so how do you actually build stuff in a simulator? Well, thankfully, it's super easy. We're going to use Tinkercad, and we'll show you exactly how to build the Hello World circuit that we made before. Okay, so here we are at Tinkercad. We'll assume you've already signed up for an account. If you haven't, you just go to the Join Now button right here, but we'll go to Sign In. And now we're at the dashboard. So this dashboard's blank because it's 3D designs. We'll go to the Circuits one, and here you will see previous designs that we've created, but for us right now, we'll go to create new circuit. And this is it. This is kind of where all the magic happens. You're gonna drag and drop components over from the right-hand side over to the workspace right here, and then you'll be able to click code and write code for your design. So let's just quickly go through it. And one thing to note is here's the components, but there's also these starter assemblies you can click. So if you went to Arduino right here and clicked blink, that is actually the exact, I'll just do it. So click on that and then you move your mouse over and then click one more time. And there we've dropped the actual circuit. It looks a little bit different one than I made, but that's a functioning circuit right there. We can just show you start simulation and yep, it works as advertised. Okay, so let's create it from scratch. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do is make sure we have components selected here. We'll type in Arduino, and then you see the UNO 3. Again, click it once, move it over to where you want it in the workspace, click again, and there you have it. To pan the view around, you're just gonna wanna click and hold, and then move around. Next, let's drop a breadboard. So we'll drop this one right here, click once. Again, I can move it around, click one more time. And it's placed. Next, we'll do the LED. Just click there, and here you can see you can put the cathode or anode on specific pins. We'll put it over here. One cool thing is when you click it, it allows you to change the color of the actual LED. Next, resistor. Oops. Okay. Again, we'll drop it right here. Set the resistance value. You can see the colors correspond with that. And next, we just have to wire it up. So here's how straightforward it is. I'm going to want to join this right here to pin 13. And I literally just click once on that pin, drag it down, and I'm into pin 13 right there. And I can move the Arduino board and make that as straight as possible if I wanted to. Now, one other cool thing is we'll click once, and we're going to take this one to ground. I could just go straight line to ground, but just to demonstrate this, every time you click once, you put a node in the wire. So I can make it basically S-turn as much as I want it to, and that really allows you to keep things organized. Another thing that will allow you to stay very organized is changing the colors of the wire. So you can see how much faster that is than trying to use actual physical hardware. You're able to create things so quickly. So that's the actual circuit built. And going into the code, you can see it's already preloaded with a sketch. It's in block view. You can see that it's going to basically blink or send, it's going to digitally write pin 13 high, it's going to wait for 1 second, then it's going to write it low, and they'll go back through the loop. So the code is already written. As soon as you hit start simulation, it will automatically upload it to the board. So let's do that. And there you go. That's our functioning hello world blinking circuit. One thing to note here, which can be very frustrating, is sometimes you'll click that and you'll be looking at the code and, okay, this all makes sense. Oh, actually, I want to change something. Well, if you don't hit stop simulation and you try to move something, nothing will happen. You won't actually be able to do anything. And it's very frustrating until you figure out what's actually going on. It's easy to tell with this blinking LED right now, but if you don't have an LED that indicates that the program is running, the only way you'll know is this one box right here. And same thing, if you try to type stuff in there, you can't. So that's how you build a very, very basic Hello World circuit in Tinkercad. So there's lots of really cool things about Tinkercad. And let's take a look at a little bit more of the educational side. This is the main view you'll see. And all your designs will be loaded in here. Let's go to Learn. And then just make sure you click over here back to Circuits. And then they have lots of starter lessons, lots of projects that will really help you understand different aspects to both using Arduino as well as just basic electronic circuitry. But my favorite one out of all these is you go to Projects and then click Show All Arduino. And then if you purchase the starter kit from arduino.cc, which I did a long time ago, each one of these lessons is actually corresponds to a project out of the starter kit book. So there's like 15 lessons, and each one of these corresponds to an actual project out of that book. So you can follow along either in the real world or here on Tinkercad virtually, which makes it super convenient. Now, if you're just trying to get some inspiration or learn new skills, check out new stuff, go to Gallery. Click there, and that'll load up, and make sure, again, you go to Circuits. And you can see a variety of projects here for inspiration. Now you can actually search for a more specific thing. So if you're struggling with a particular project and you want to see if there's other projects out there that are similar, it's pretty straightforward. All you have to do is just click this search button. And let's say we're looking for an Arduino alarm clock. We'll click Circuits here, and then Search. Okay, cool. So a NeoPixel clock pops up right here. Let's click on that. And here you can see everything to do with the project. A lot of comments, and the coolest part though is you can just, okay, I like that. I want to explore it now. So I click copy and tinker, and here we go. I can, no kidding, mess around with the actual design, the components, and I can even look at the code and see how this guy programmed this particular project. So you can see how there's tons of really useful stuff on Tinkercad, not only just for you to design your own circuits, but also to learn from the community, learn from others, and also get inspiration. So there you have it. We know what a simulator is, why it's cool, and how to use one. We really hope you've enjoyed this video. So how do you use a simulator? Do you like creating projects online first, or do you like to tinker in the physical world? Let us know in the comments below. We'd really appreciate it.